I went to Canada when I was 15, and I think one of the parts about going to Canada at that age is that you realize that you don't just easily fit in. You know, so I got myself into a lot of trouble, you know, in the early stages, got kicked out of school and all of that. And it was coming back from a suspension that I decided I wanted to do something different because I didn't want to be something my mother anymore. And so I started wrestling, and just the discipline that you get from the sport is really what I would say saved me. You know, and the camaraderie of just being like a team. Well, put it this way, whenever it is that when I first went to wrestling the first year, I just got beat up. And I think one of the reasons why I got beat up the first year is because I thought that I could use brute force and strength and the Batman thing to kind of get my way around. But the more I was angry when I went to practices, the more I got beat up. And so when I learned to channel that anger, you know, and just be able to be a little bit more disciplined in the moments that I've had, I got better at it. And the years to follow, yes, I'll be wrestling at 185. So, yes, I'm actually trying to get up to that weight. I'm about 5 or 6 pounds away from starting to get up to that weight. I'm just trying to keep the weight and pump up the weight because I'm going to call where I'm going. It doesn't matter to me whether or not I get up to the exact weight. I think I just like to be able to fight. When I was fighting in university and high school, I was at the cut weight to get down to the weight class that was lower. And I realized my last year of university, I just wrestled where I was. You know, so even though I was usually 5 pounds away from the weight class and 2 pounds away from the weight class, I still felt stronger. I didn't have to cut the weight, so I didn't feel dehydrated all the time. And it's the same thing now. You know, I'm 41 years old now. And you know, still being able to maintain shape or whatever the case is, but at this stage in the game, I don't want to be getting caught up and losing weight and cutting weight or anything.
Where were you your opponents from?
From all over the Commonwealth. I know Canada, India, different places in the Caribbean that are represented, Suriname. There you get quite a few places.
Do you have any idea where the toughest challenge is?
Well, the toughest challenge is India because they take their wrestling seriously, you know. But at the same time, I'm looking forward to it. I feel like I'm in the best shape that I've ever been in. I'm stronger than I've ever been. And mentally, I feel I really
feel
it.
How did you initiate this new stage to come here?
Well, look, I came back to Jamaica. My brothers and I came back to Jamaica in 1999 when I finished university. And after I was working in Canada for a while, I decided to come home. And ever since I came home, the Commonwealth has been wanting to see some kind of wrestling come out of Jamaica. Because, I mean, we're natural. I mean, when you look at the guys running around, natural. And so they've been after me for a while to do this thing, and I've been putting it off because I've always had something, but I've always been busy, you know, with a whole bunch of stuff. But the timing, when they called me this year, the timing just felt right. And then I decided to look back at, you know, just the role the sport played in my life and how it changed my life. I just wanted to make a difference in Jamaica, especially after working in the prisons, you know, doing the work that I do in the schools, trying to get these kids to understand that there's more to life than what it is that they're doing now. You know what I mean? And prepare them for their future. And I think a sport